Which of the following will come in the place of question mark? So we need to identify which of the following will come in the place of question mark. So let's try to identify the logic between the numbers. So first, let's try to take the first one. So 15, and they gave us brackets with 79 and then 4. So if you observe, 15 and 4, if I just multiply this both, 15 into 4 is just 60, but it is 79 here. So 79, which multiple of 15 is so close? 15 into 5 is so close. So what I can think is, here it is 4. Okay, so they might have did 15 into the number here, 4 plus 1 plus 4. This entire thing plus 4. Plus 4 is nothing but this particular number. See, 15 into 5. 15 into 5 is 75. 75 plus 4 is 79. Satisfied? So maybe they multiplied the first number with second plus 1 and the resultant they added the second number. That might be the logic. So how can you decide your logic whether it is correct or not? You need to apply for the next one too. If that's satisfied, then definitely it might be the logic. So we will quickly check. So 25, 4, 15 and next 15. So according to us, it should be 25 into 15 plus 1. Plus the second number, that means 15. So 25 into 16 here. 15 plus 1 is 16. So 25 into 16 is 400. 400 plus 15, 415. Satisfied? So 415 satisfied. So if you want, you can even apply here. You can even apply here. So this is going to become 13 into 12 plus 1. 12 plus 1 is nothing but 13 itself. Plus 12. Yes, so 13 into 13 is 169. 169. Plus 12. 169 plus 12 is nothing but 181. Satisfied? This condition also satisfied. So now we need to apply here. So 22 into the second number plus 1 means 6 plus 1 plus the second number, which is 6. The resultant plus the second number. So 22 into 7 plus 6. Right. So 22 into 7 is 154. 154 plus 6 will be the answer. So 154 plus 6 is how much? 160. So what's the answer? Option A. So the answer for this question is option A. Which of the following will come in the place of question mark? So they gave us a series here and we need to identify which of the following will come in the place of this question mark. So let's try to absorb the numbers. So here 9 is in the middle of this 4 numbers. So let's try to think there is a logic that is formed between this 4 numbers to get 9. Let's try to think in that manner. That means here also there is a logic formed between the 4 numbers to get 10. Like that. We'll just think first. If we get, it's fine, or else we will think in a different manner. Now I had 8, 4, 12 and 7. Okay. Now I need to get 9. So how do I get? Let's try to add them. Okay, first let's try to add them. So if I add the opposite faces, maybe. I think maybe. If it is not, we will try to check it in a reverse manner. So if I add the opposite faces, that means 8 plus 7. So here 8 plus 7 and there it is 4 plus 12. So 8 plus 7 is 15 and then 4 plus 12 is 16. 4 plus 12 is 16. No, this is not going to give us. The difference is also not 9. Even if we multiply or if we do, we won't get it. So this is not going to happen. Now let's try to take the adjacent faces. That means either this 2 or this 2, something like that. So now let's try to take this 2. So 4 plus 8. 4 plus 8 is 12. 12 plus 7. So 12 plus 7 here. So 12 plus 7 is how much? 19. Right. Let's try to check the differences between them. 19 and 12, the difference is not 9. Means the resultant is not going to come. Now I will take this 2. Maybe I'm just checking whether we get or not. So now I'm going to take this 2. That means 8 plus 12 I'll take. So the adjacent faces I'm taking, which is 20. And then 4 plus 7 I will take. So 4 plus 7 is almost 11. So the difference is 9. Satisfied? Yes. So might be the logic. That means this two faces addition first, and then this differences should give you the resultant one. So let's try to check whether that is going to happen in this particular thing or not. That means I'll take these numbers now. So 15, I need to add with 26. So 15 plus 26 is how much? 41. Now I need to add 19 and 12 here. So 19 plus 12 is how much? 31. See the difference? 10 satisfied? 10 satisfied. So the same thing we will apply here. So we will take this one now. So this two I need to add, and this two I need to add, then I should take the differences between that, right? So 32 plus 18, 32 plus 18 is nothing but 50 here. And similarly, we'll check this one, 26 plus 6, which is 32. So what is the differences between them? It is nothing but 18. 50 and 32 difference is 18. So what should be the number here? 18. Even that is there in our option also. So what is the answer? Option C. So what we did first, we checked with the opposite faces, because the numbers here are so close, there might be no chance for multiplication. So might be it will be an addition or subtraction itself. So first we checked with the opposite faces, then we checked with the adjacent faces. So this adjacent face did not give us, and this gave us. Yes, so what's the answer for this question? Option C. Find the missing number. So we need to identify what is the missing number. So how do we do? So first, if I take the smallest number among this, which is 12, if I check with 12, 12 plus 1 is 13, that's fine. 13 plus 2 is 15, that is also correct. So 15 plus 3 is 18. 18 plus 4 is 22. 22 plus 5 is 27. Perfect. But now here comes 27 plus 6, if I do, that's 33. 33 is not there in the option at all. 33 is not there in the option. Plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4, plus 5, plus 6, if I think. That's not there in the option. So that's not going to be our logic. Yes, because the last one is not going to satisfy here. Yes. So the last one is not going to satisfy. That is for sure. Because plus 6 is not going to happen. So we started from here. Why can't we start from here itself? We might think there is a some number. And then your plus 0 happened. Plus 0, plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4, plus 5. So that's correct only, right? So first we checked with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That doesn't work out. So instead of starting with 12, we can start with this unknown number itself. Why I'm starting with this unknown number? Because 12 is also there in the option. So if I just think this is 12. So 12 plus 0 is 12 itself. Then plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4, plus 5. That means they added first 0, then they added 1, then they added 2, then they added 3, 4, 5. So the answer is correct. So what's the answer? Option C. Why I'm taking this? Because if you take any other number, for example, if I consider 14 here, that's not going to satisfy any kind of logic, because this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that is fixed. So if you take 14 here, again, plus 2, minus 2 will come. 14 to 12, it's minus 2. Or else if you go from 27 to 14 also, it is not going to satisfy. Even if you take 34 also, that is the same case. Because all of a sudden, from 24, that became either 27, it became either 34 or 35. That means either plus 7 or plus 8 is the increase. So that's also not going to happen. All of a sudden, plus 7 or plus 8 will not come into picture, because here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, they are completely in an order. So definitely it should be like plus 0, plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4, plus 5. So what is the answer for this question? Option C. Which of the following will come in the place of question mark? So what will come in the place of question mark? So here we need to identify what will be the number. So let's try to observe the alphabets first. Let's try to give the numberings for the alphabets, because we had the numbers here. So B is 2, A is 5, J is 7, and here we don't know. So let's try to first look, maybe the pattern performed between this two to get 30. Let's try to look in that particular manner. If we did not get, then we will check in a different manner. So if I check, 5 into 2 is not going to give me 30. Even if I do addition or multiplication, that is not going to happen. 30 is little huge number compared to 2 and 5. Let's try with the squares. So 2 square is 4 and 5 square is 25. Why I'm trying with squares is 5 square is 25, we know. And this was so close to 25. So if I add it, I'm going to get 29. Maybe I'll think they did the squares and they added 1 to that. Okay, so we will just think in that manner. That means 2 square plus 5 square plus 1. We will think in this manner. We will apply here. If we get, then it's fine. Or else we'll try identifying a different logic. So now it should be 5 square plus 7 square plus 1. Right. So which is 25 plus 49 plus 1. So 25 plus 49 is 74. 74 plus 1, 75 satisfied. Okay. That means here also 7 square plus some number. We don't know what is this number. X square plus plus 1 should give us 171. We don't know what is this particular alphabet here. That alphabet number we don't know. Let us just think it as x. So now 7 square is 49. 49 plus x square plus 1 is equals to 171. That means x square is equals to 121. So x is nothing but 11. So which alphabet is 11? It's nothing but K. Yes, so K is 11. So what's the answer for this question? It is option B. So they did the squaring of the alphabets. They added them, and for the resultant, they added 1 also. Okay, so what's the answer for this question? Option B. Which of the following will come in the place of question mark? So we need to identify which of the following will come in the place of question mark. So to identify that, first I will make use of the numbers here, because always it is easy for us to identify for the numbers. Yes, so let's try to make use of the numbers here. So what are the numbers here? 2, 3, 5, 17. So, and there is a number here which we don't know. Okay, and then it should become 17. So 2 became 3. So what are the possible chances that 2 can become 3 plus 1? But 3 plus 2 is 5, but after 5 plus 3 will not work out, because it is all of a sudden it is 17 here. So then what else I can do? 2 into 1 plus 1 will give me 3. That is one thing which satisfied. Or 2 into 2 minus 1 will also give me 3. So any of this might be the logic. So how do I decide which is correct? By applying for the next one, I'll decide. So for example, if I do 2 into 1 plus 1 here, which is 3, this is also a correct logic. Or 2 into 2 minus 1, which is 3, this is also a correct logic. So now 3 became 5. That means if I do 3 into 1 plus 2, that will become 5. Or else, even if I do 3 into 2 minus 1, into 2 minus 1, into 2 minus 1, that is also going to become 5 itself. So here into 1 plus 1, into 2 plus 3. Okay, so here again, into 1 plus 3 I should do. Yes, into 1 plus 3 is 8. So next 8 into 1 plus 4 should give me 17. But that is not going to happen. 8 into 1 plus 4 is not going to give us 17. So that's wrong. Right, so this is wrong. That means this logic is wrong. If you carefully observe, this logic is actually wrong, because we are just multiplying with into 1. Okay, so I'm just saying most of you also will think in the same manner. That's why I said. Okay, so if I apply for 8, it should give me 17, but that is not going to happen. That's why this logic is wrong. Now let's check in this logic. So here it is, 5 into 2 minus 1 should give us 10, 10 minus 1, which is 9. So if I think the next one is 9, so let's apply for 9 and check whether it is going to give us 17 or not. 9 into 2 minus 1, 17 satisfied. That means our logic is correct. So definitely the number here should be 9. That means these two options would be eliminated. So now we know 2x, 3y, 5a and 9 and a number, comma 17 and m. So we found out the number. So now we need to identify the alphabet also, because we had two options with 9. Either it is F or E, we need to identify. So let's first give the numberings here. So basically x is 24 and y is 25. And A from the starting, if we write it is 1, or if we write it from the reverse, that means if Z is 26, again A will be 27. It will be again counted. So A can be 0 or A can be 27. I'm taking 27 because if you observe, this is in terms of increasing order, right? So now let's try to identify the logic here. And the 2M here is 13. So here plus 1, if I think plus 1, and here also plus 2. Actually, this is correct. But plus 3, if I do, after A plus 3 if I do, or 1 plus 3 if I do, it should give me D. But D is not there in the option. So that's not going to be the logic. Plus 1 plus 2 plus 3 is not going to be the logic. Even if I apply for D, I won't get M. So that is not going to be the logic. So now let's think in a different manner. So maybe they use the numbers here. Maybe the numbers which are before them, they might have used. So let's try to think in that particular manner. Now, if you observe here, this is definitely the difference is 1. We can't change it. And here the difference is also 2. That means maybe x before number is 2. 2 minus 1. 2 minus 1 is 1. So they has added plus 1. Now 3 minus 1 is how much? 2. They had added 2. Now similarly 5 minus 1. 5 minus 1 is how much? 4. That means for 1, 4 will be added. Right, A is nothing but 1. For 1, 4 will be added. 4 will be added means it will become 5, which is nothing but E. Yes, so E is there in the option. How do I decide that is correct or not? By applying it for the next one. So 9 minus 1 is how much? 8. If I apply 5 plus 8, I'm going to get 13. Satisfied M also. So correct? So then before number, the alphabet before number, they just did minus 1 and whatever the result is, they all added to the alphabet. So X for X plus 2 minus 1, the number before X is 2. And similarly, Y plus 3 minus 1. And next, A plus 5 minus 1. So similarly, now we need to do for E to check whether we get M or not. If we get M, then that's correct. So already we got E here. So E plus 9 minus 1, M also came. So correct. Our logic is correct. So what's the answer for this question? It will be option D. Thank you for watching the video till the end. If you like the video, do not forget to press the like button. And you can also join our social media platforms like Telegram group, Instagram page, and WhatsApp group. The links for all of them are in the description box. Thank you.